the facility of Forks Broadcasting in Olney, Illinois. And this game is meant solely for the enjoyment of our listening audience. It's brought to you by our loyal list of Tiger, Lady Tiger basketball sponsors, and is under the supervision of Sports Director Mark Weiler. Get set. It's time for Olney Tiger, Olney Lady Tiger basketball on Freedom 92.9. And now, to the gym.
And welcome everyone. Ron here in gym. Pretty good crowd at hand for the Friday night basketball action. Really a wide night conference basketball. Here this evening between the visiting Tigers at Paris and the Denver County and our own Tigers here in Richland County at RCHS. We welcome you to a trust-based pregame show without sponsor of all these Richland County sports. Mark Weiler alongside with Dave Berry for our broadcast here tonight. And Dave, even though you have these records, we all know that you throw those records out. We had to talk about it in postseason, but really throughout the season.
Yeah, they don't mean anything really. They're kind of a gauge as far as how your own team is playing, but you never know how your team is going to react to the opponent you're playing on a given night. So you got to play your own game, and if we knew we should be okay, but if not, it's a good type of game.
Yeah. Paris comes in this game with a 2-3-7 record, and they are 0-2 of the conference, while the Tigers kind of on the other end of the spectrum at 8-1. They are 1-0 in conference play. And when you look at the rest of the LIC, when you check that courtesy of Paramount, their truck and trailer repair, you see that Aldi sitting atop the league, undefeated at 1-0. You also have Newton, Lawrenceville, both at 1-0. Then Marshall, Mount Carmel, and Robinson all at 1-1. Casey Westfield at 0-1, and Bears at 0-2 in league action. Then you have two other league games tonight, Newton and Robinson, which ought to be a pretty good game there, along with Marshall and Lawrenceville. The first non-conference game tonight, Casey Westfield is hosting Fairfield, and Mount Carmel is hosting Evansville Day School. And then there's a host of games coming up tomorrow, and of course next Tuesday. More of those over when we get into our halftime show here later in the conference. But look at the LIC conference standings and other games. I brought you that they bought their truck and trailer there and all these sound industrial parts. So the Tigers have come in pretty impressive wins, you know, and you get into Southwest then we were in the Capital Classic, beat Morrisville in a tough game, the championship game. Also, Robinson in their home opener here, only a 7-point victory. Robinson was telling the Trebles for time to for the Tigers. They turned around and played well against Carbondale at a neutral location. And then a bad loss against a very good team up at Mount Lyon against the Braves. Then took care of Batu. They were now in Salem earlier in the week on the road. They're trying to wrap up this first part of their schedule with Paris here tonight. We're going to Effingham to play St. Anthony, and then we'll be in the Dr. Thomas Booth staff at Kentucky Bell for four games there. So, kind of progressing through this process as a schedule for the only Tigers.
They've been pretty good throughout, particularly on defense. You've been putting up only 42 points per game, and holding their opponents down to a 43% shooting from the field. So, that's pretty good.
Yeah. Tigers get rid of this game. We're going to talk about stats. I can't remember the coach or broadcaster. You always talk about stats. Tigers average 47 points per game. Pretty low when you think about that with some of the offense that's going on around the high school level at this time. But they only give up 38 points potentially. And it's something really a combination game between ball control and defense for the Tigers.
The Tigers are kind of a unique team. You think of them as maybe not being real quick on offense. They score the majority of their points in transition or free throw line. If they don't have a transition shot, then the game gets pretty deliberate. But they're pretty hard to catch up on if they get you down. Because the 10-12 point lead to the 10-12 point deficit to the Tigers late in the game is a lot more than that.
Yeah. Well, we're listening to our Trust Bank Weekend Show. Trust Bank, proud sponsor of all the Richland County sports. You can see what they have to offer you. Go to their website at trustbank.com. Gaudet. Let's go ahead and check our starting lineup for these three teams. There are Tigers, coach by Chase Brinkley. Chase, of course, is one time assistant coach out at Albany Central College, playing ball there as well. And now back at home, coaching his home squad, the Paris High School. Well, he's starting the 5'8 junior, Jackson Lipton, one of their top scorers. Modelo Jr., 6'3" Drew Rogers at center, will be a sophomore, 6'2" Carter Eastham. And then at the forward spot, senior 6 foot Peyton Holster and a 6 foot junior Jacob Salem. So the Rinkin, Rogers, Holster, Salem, and Eastham. The coach Chase Brinkley. He's assisted by Zach Walls, Rod Redrick, and Don Lee. The only Tigers is coach Ralph Flanagan. They'll be starting 5'11" senior Ian Leifert. The other guard slot, 6 foot junior R.J. Keller. At the forward slot, 6'6" junior Rex Allen. The 6'2" senior Colby Redman. And at center, the 6'8" sophomore Casey Selman. The Lisa back in the lineup after sitting out this past Tuesday due to ankle injuries. Along with Keller, Allen, Redman, and Selman. Starting lineups,
good night.
And Jimmy Fallenbacher, the Council Financial Representative for Rich Lennon. Aldi and Aldi area, for all of your insurance and financial needs, give Jimmy a call and he'll hook you up. A scoreboard check here tonight, as always, brought to you by Eric Keller, your Prudential insurance agent. Timeout brought to you by Bell Pizza. And a webcast, the freedom929.com, brought to you by Eagles Automotive Center, Aldi and Brooklyn County's only new car and truck dealership. Dave, you know, when you look at the Paris Tigers, you look at what is happening here as of now, and of course, Chase Brinkley is in his, I believe, fifth year as the head coach at the Paris, and again, as we mentioned earlier, coming back home after straying away somewhat to play some junior college ball.
Yeah, he's back in his hometown, and I think he's very good coach, and I think his team is going to play really hard tonight. I don't know too much about him. I see they were beat pretty bad by Decapolis, and but they beat some other teams in their immediate area, smaller schools, and you never know.
Yeah, this is Chase's fifth year. He succeeds Sean Nugent, who is here 9 years, Jim Belasco, 4 years over a 6-year period. In between that, Terry Elston did some coaching. But if you talk about Paris basketball, you talk about Ernie Anglin, who was there in the 30s, 40s, and 50s, 21 years, and 592 wins, 125 losses.
And a couple of state titles, I think.
Yeah, they had 18 regionals, 11 sectionals, 9 state appearances, finished third once, and the second twice of 2 state titles. Both of those were back in the 40s. So that's why they named the old gym after Ernie up in Paris. A lot of history that a lot of people don't know about because it's been several years ago.
Right, right.
Well, hey, we're going to step aside as we get ready to return for the opening tip-off. It's the Albany Tigers getting set to take on the Marshall Tigers here this afternoon and evening. And Ron here in Chip, we will be back with your opening tip and more coming up. This is Albany Tiger basketball.
When nothing in the freezer, nothing in the fridge looks good for dinner, try a little pizza plan. Call for a famous, fabulous, genuine Joe's Pizza. The most rewarding, appetite-appeasing, change-of-pace dinner a family can put in their face. Have it topped with extra cheese, mushrooms, pepperoni, or whatever you want. Joe's Pizza, an authentic Italian food, is all made with their secret old-world recipe. Remember Joe's also for your next catered event. Call Joe's Pizza, 392-8551. Joe's Pizza on North Jefferson in Albany. Pizza so good, might as well get two.
A proud supporter of this broadcast is Doris Brothers Trophies in Noble. We offer all types of trophies, medals and ribbons, laser computerized full-color plaques and picture plaques, plus screen printing and other custom services, all with wholesale pricing. With a Better Business Bureau A-plus rating, look us up online, DorisBROS.com. We are the original. We are the best. We are Doris Brothers Trophies in Noble.
since 1954. Yes, over 60 years ago, Dahls began their business in Richland County. Now in their third generation, they offer the only computerized concrete plant in Richland County. Dahls offer stone in several sizes for your drive and projects. They have landscape rock and dirt. If you need excavation or demolition work, Dahls is the place to call. For concrete and more, for 60 plus years, call 618-393-2153.
Having issues with your ears, nose, or throat? Or maybe you need to establish care with a provider for allergy treatment. Stephanie Zuber, ENT and allergy physician assistant, is able to care for these types of issues locally. Stephanie can help both children and adults get relief from common ears, nose, and throat issues, and can assist her patients with allergy testing and treatment. If you feel you could benefit from specialized ENT or allergy treatment, ask your regular provider for a referral for Stephanie's services.
Barenbacher Truck and Trailer Repair, located on Radio Tower Lane in Alney, specializes in Caterpillar and Cummins engines, providing full maintenance service with two full-time service trucks, computer engine service, welding, turn flywheel, hunter alignment service. Call 618-395-1380, 618-395-1380. That's Barenbacher Truck and Trailer Repair in Alney.
Are you a first-time home buyer looking to remodel your existing home or making plans to build your dream home on that perfect piece of land? Citizens National Bank of Albion is this area's most trusted lender, and for good reason. Come in today to speak with one of our professional mortgage lenders and experience the difference our competitive rates and solid decision-making can make for you and your family.
Citizens National Bank of Albion, no better banking, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Tigers have been the home white tonight.